Hello YouTube. I'm going to be reading A New Concept of the Universe, written by Walter Russell. Octave Wave Cycles, number 48. In order to comprehend the great simplicity which underlies the seemingly complex series of 9 octaves which constitute the periodic tables of the elements, together with the simplicity which underlies atomic structure, it would be well to paint a word picture of nature's basic desire and her simple manner of attaining her desire. Let us, therefore, vision a man who is laying down to rest. He is in thorough equilibrium with his environment, for every part of his body occupies the same pressure relation which the Earth's center of gravity. In this balanced position, he is without the strains and tensions of electric division of his equilibrium. This position of unchanging pressures is in a plane of 90 degrees from the radial direction of changing pressures which release outward from the center of gravity into space. The moment this man desires to demonstrate action for the fulfillment of his desires, he must rise from this plane of rest until he acquires the radial angle of 90 degrees to it. Even though he can find balance when thus standing erect, he must be awake and his senses alert in order to maintain balance. Otherwise, he would fall to the zero level from which he rose. The reason for this is because he has divided his balance into 2 equal balances, which are controlled by the one centered in him. Eventually, he can no longer electrically control his own balance against the resistance of the 2 opposing conditions he has set up by the extending gravity into the forever changing pressure conditions which exist in radial directions. The polarized condition which he created by his desire for action now expresses his desire for the one balanced condition of rest and returns his body to the zero of equal pressures from which it rose. The above is a true symbolic word picture of every action reaction of every happening to every body in the universe. It is also a true picture of growth decay and life death sequences. I shall now relate the above universal principle to the octave waves of the elements of matter and to the gyroscopic principle which controls the octave periodicity of the elements of matter. I shall also describe how the gyroscopic principle operates with the north cell magnetic poles, which control the extension of polarizing thought wave bodies from their fulcrums to their wave amplitudes, and east-west poles, which control the withdrawals of depolarizing thought wave bodies from their fulcrums from their amplitudes.